to another episode of Journey Hotline, a series of interviews conducted by the Gava Club of University of Colombo, where the most prominent public speakers of Sri Lanka will be sharing their words of wisdom and amazing experiences about their life with you. I'm Purvi Rukun, and today we are meeting someone who has become the talk of the town in the music industry. He lives a double life, alternating between an ordinary student and a talented singer. He also emerged runners-up in the popular TV show The Voice Teens, which made him a star overnight on a global scale. Today, he's a fitting reminder that the future of our music industry is in capable hands. So without further ado, let's meet this superstar. Ladies and gentlemen, put our hands together and welcome Navodya Perera. Hello, Navodya.
Hello, Aki. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for inviting me. Thank you so much for having me.
So how are you doing?
I'm good. Like these days, I'm more focusing. I'm like I'm only focusing on A levels, my A levels. So I'm like a bit distant from music career, from my music career. So like I'm mainly focusing on my studies. So yeah.
Okay, let's get started. So my first question is, how would you like to define yourself? Who is Navodya Perera?
Navodya Perera is someone who's like so in love with music, arts and literature. So now this is an ordinary student. Like, he's still studying, he's still doing his A-levels. So Navodya had a musical background. Again, it's like I from childhood I had a musical background. So I'm from Nigambo. So as Nigambians, we all have like a musical background. So I started singing when I was 5 years old. And yeah, that's how it's been. Like since from since my childhood, I've been in love with music. So that's now it.
Yeah, okay. So participating in the Voice Teens was probably the biggest opportunity. So you got to learn and interact with the veterans in the industry. So how did that affect on you and what was that experience?
Voice turned my life upside down. So I had like, I got many great opportunities. I got the chance to meet really important people in the industry, like my coach Sankadinet, and Coach Lahiru, Coach Raini, and Coach Abhisheka. I got the opportunity to like get more experience about the industry and like in the Sri Lankan music industry as well as the media industry. So Sirasa TV was like super supportive and they provided us this platform. So I'm really grateful. I'm really grateful to God and I'm really grateful to my parents. For like sending me to Voice.
Yeah, okay, nice. So something that many people deal is stage fright. We all have that phobia. So we can't sometimes convince ourselves to get up on stage and perform. So how did you deal with these insecurities, emotions and feelings?
Shall I call you Purvi Yaki or something? Okay, so actually, yeah, I'm someone who had like a lot of insecurities like in growing up. You know, I had like this insecurity about my teeth. You know, everyone knows about my teeth. The whole sign knows about this. So, and you know, I had like, I had stage fear, but you know, after going into Voice, actually the coaches and all the production team, they actually take a lot of effort to improve our self confidence and like they actually give us really like, give us many activities to like improve our confidence and lecture us about these things. So it really helped us like in not only like getting away from stage fear but also improving our self confidence and like in life also. It's really a great opportunity to be trained by those professionals.
Okay, so as a newcomer to this industry of music, who is immensely popular, there is a considerable amount of pressure on you because you have to keep that success going on. So how do you deal with it while also living the life of an ordinary student?
Yeah, it's like we have to maintain that standard, right? Like after being a finalist, I have to maintain that standard, that fame. I have keep it going. So it's really hard as a student, and also I have to focus on my studies mainly. Otherwise, I'll be a failure in another in my study stream. So it's actually really hard, but I'm willing to take that challenge. Like we all are, the finalists and the semi-finalists, we all have the same experience because we are on the same age, in the same age. So we are willing to take that challenge, and we are willing to do something for the industry while improving ourselves in higher studies and other aspects in our lives.
It's happy to see you are willing to take that challenge. Can you sing a song for us?
Yeah, for sure. Do I need to play some kind of instrument or something? Is it okay
fine.
If I sing?
It's fine, okay. If you can. Yeah.
Okay. So my older brother, my Aya is here with me. So he's my my personal guitarist. So so this is one of my favorite songs. This is my all-time favorite songs from John Legend. So I actually once sang this in front of a crowd, recently. So I'll sing All of Me for you. Do you mind?
Whoever tried to do is all your smooth, you kicking me out. Got my head spin, no kidding, in your bed. What's going on in that beautiful night? I'm on your magical mystery ride, and I'm sorry. Alright, my head breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of mind. 'Cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me and give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning, even when I lose a bit. 'Cause I gave you all of me. You gave me all of you. Oh. How many times do I have to tell you Even when you're crying, you're beautiful tonight. The world is beating me down. I'm around through every night. You're my downfall, you're my muse. My first distraction, I realize. Can't stop singing, it's ringing in my head for you. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of my mind. 'Cause all of me, that's all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me, I give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning, even when I lose a bit. 'Cause I give you all of me. And you give me all of you. Oh.
Thank you. Actually, you're muted.
Sorry. Thank you for singing, Praz, and I must say that you've got an amazing talent.
Thank you so much.
So let's get back to our questions. So the music industry on a global scale is growing at an exponential rate and it's very futuristic. So what are your plans to keep up with the global trends and developments in the industry?
Actually, my plan, like my personal plan is to mix the Sri Lankan music, like mix the Sri Lankan traditional music and like the Western music and like I need to do something like new and something a mix of cultures, okay? So that's my plan. So my coach is there to guide me. So my coach, Coach Sankar Dinet, he's planning to do a new original for me. So he's the one who's gonna do the first song for me. So let's see what it's gonna be. So that's my hint. So I'm gonna mix Western music and Sri Lankan traditional music into one.
Yeah, I'm sure that is going to be exciting. So we all know balancing is a hard game. Balancing your academics, extracurriculars, and your music career is a difficult job. We know that. So what's your strategy to cope up with all of this work you have?
Sorry, I couldn't hear you. Your last sentence.
Okay. So balancing is always a hard game. So balancing your studies, yeah, extracurricular activities, music career, it's a difficult job. So what's your strategy to cope up with all of this?
I have a habit of listing down my tasks. I'm for every day, I make a to-do list. So that's how I actually manage all these things. So I list down my tasks. So, excuse me. One of my friends. So moving back to the question, listing down the tasks I have to do is the main thing I do in order to complete all my tasks. So I'm actually the head prefect of our school, and so I have a lot of responsibilities in school and also with my academics too. So in order to fulfill all these things, like that's how I actually do everything in order. Yeah, that's my strategy.
Okay, nice. So,
like you can see I'm really a nervous speaker. You see me as like a performer on stage, but I have this like a social anxiety in me. So
that's totally okay, because practice make you perfect. That's what you perfect. Yeah. So going to our next question. So in your opinion, why is self-confidence an important factor in achieving your goals and targets? Why is that important?
Self-confidence is like if you believe in yourself, if you believe that you can do this thing, like I believe that I'm a good performer. It's not actually bragging, but I believe that I can do, like, I can do this thing. So in the beginning of the voice stage, I was like, I'm not good enough. I'm not suitable for this stage. But when I started practicing more, when I started training myself, I got the idea that, you know, I can do this. Like, if anyone can do this, like, we have seen a lot of small kids, like small children singing voice global, right? So like in Europe and in America. So like from a really young age, they start performing like great artists. So if they can do it, why can't we? So like that's how I build up my confidence, actually. And it's been my dream since childhood to perform in global stage like voice. So I asked myself, so if this was your dream, why don't you do everything in your power to achieve it, right? So that's how I actually built up my confidence. I wrote a little quote, a little quote for myself. It's like this: if this was your dream, like, why don't you the quote was, if this was your dream, why don't you do everything in your power to do it, right? So you have to take every risk in order to achieve that dream. Yeah.
Yes, indeed. Self-confidence is the key to achieve everything in our life. Now that you have come a long way, and I'm sure many people have supported you through this journey. So what do you have to say to them?
I have to this is the thing. So as I said before, if you believe in yourself, if you believe what you do, it can be music, it can be studies, it can be sports. But if you believe in yourself, if you believe that you can achieve something great, you have to continue it. And if you love something, if you love a certain area, it can be any stream, it can be any part. If you believe that you can do it, if you really born to achieve that, you should continue it. The gut feeling, you should believe your gut feeling, right? So if your gut is telling you to do this thing, you have to believe it, and you have to continue going in that path. So my gut feeling was in my early stage of voice, it was my greatest dream to be to be a performer, to be a singer, to show my voice, show my voice and show my talents to the world. So that was my gut feeling. That was my greatest ambition. So I kept going in that path. I kept practicing. I kept training myself. I kept improving myself in order to achieve that dream. So actually, confidence, practice, and confidence, practice, and the, you know, we have to be unstoppable. Like, even when people say that you can't do this, you won't be able to do this, we should have that confidence in us to like be resilient, right? So practice and resilience and confidence makes us, like, drives us to our dream. So that's my only advice for the newcoming artists. You have to practice, and you have to be like, you have to be an expert in what you do. So keep practicing, keep building up your confidence. So that's my only advice.
So now, can you sing a few lines of Rewrite the Stars for us?
Okay, sure. Let me get the lyrics. Okay. I haven't really practiced this song before. Like, I've never sang it. But let's try. Let's give it a try.
You know I won't play. It's not a secret I tried to hide. I know you want me, so don't keep saying I held so tight. Your claim is not in the gods, and fate is pulling you miles away. Out of reach from me, but you're here in my heart. So who can stop me if I decide that you're my destiny? What if we rewrite the stars? Say you were made to be mine. Nothing could keep us apart. You'd be the one I was meant to find. It's up to you, it's up to me. No one can say what we get to be. Why don't we rewrite the stars? Maybe the world could be us tonight.
Is it okay?
Thank you so much for singing that song for
Thank
us.
You.
So with that, we have come to the end of our questions for the session. But we have one more game prepared before we wind up for today. This final game is called If You Were, where you will have to imagine yourself in different situations and respond.
Okay.
Let's start with an easy one. Okay, are you ready to go?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Yeah, okay. So the first one is, if you were a song, you'd be...
If I was a song,
what would you be?
Okay. I think I'll be. Have you heard the song called Unstoppable by Sia?
Yeah.
So I think I would be that song.
Okay. Nice. So if you were a celebrity, what would you be?
If I was a celebrity, I think I'll be Bruno Mars. I don't know.
Okay. So, if you were a brand, what it would be?
A brand. I'll be Gucci.
So if you were a country, what that would be?
If I were a country. So it's like I have to like answer according to my personality, right?
Yeah.
I'll be Australia. I chose that answer because, you know, Australia is like a country that has like every kind of culture and every kind of nationality, right? So I actually enjoy like every musical genre, every movie genre. So that's why I chose that answer.
Okay, so I think I know the answer for next one, but here I'm asking again. So if you were an instrument, what that would be?
Okay, can you guess?
I think it's guitar.
Actually, yeah, but my favorite instrument is the piano. So if I was an instrument, I'll be a piano.
Piano, nice. Okay, so if you were an app, what that would be?
Sorry?
If you were an app, a mobile
app, what that would be? I'll be Snapchat or Pinterest.
Nice. Okay, so if you were a number, what that would be?
Number. I'll be number 7.
Is there any reason for that?
It's actually the reason for the reason for that answer is my birthday is on 7th of June. 7th of June, so yeah.
Yeah, he would prefer 7, okay. So if you were an adventure, what that would be?
An adventure. Avenger, okay, sorry. Avenger, sorry. If I was an Avenger, I'll be Thor, I think, because I love mythology.
Okay, so the last one. If you were a type of food, what's that type would be?
Type of food. I'll be a pizza.
That was an amazing game, and sadly, it also marks the end of our podcast session today. So I would like to extend my heartfelt thanks on behalf of the Gabo Club of University of Colombo to Navodya Perera for taking time off his busy schedule to join us. We wish you all the very best in your future endeavors and hope you become an iconic musician in Sri Lanka.
Thank you so much.
And with that, we bid farewell to our amazing audience. We will see you guys next week with another exciting interview. Signing off for today with the entire crew, it's Purvi. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button and do not hesitate to send us your comments. Hope you have a pleasant week ahead. Thank you.
Actually, thank you for having me. It's actually a great opportunity. And thank you, Purvi Akki and Sahanayi and Ravindaya. So, I really enjoyed it. I'm sorry if I seem too nervous. So keep doing what you do. It's really actually really inspirational, and yeah.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you so much.